nobody changes the world.
Standing in the crowd,
nobody's voice is ever heard
until they open their mouth.
Won't let a loud go quiet, won't let the saints go silent. Let's turn it up, tell the world what we're about.
Blessings that you've given us. We ask that you be with all of us to protect everyone, and I hope that and I pray that you bless the service in your name. Amen.
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 Hallelujah, hallelujah. here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. And you are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are.
Stop, you never stop working. what God is. In the midst of whatever you're going through right here, right now, God is a way maker. He will make a way. The Bible says the word is a lamp unto our feet. So no matter what you're going through, no matter what circumstance, no matter what situation, no matter what storm you're walking through, no matter what battle you are walking through right now, God will make a way. Now all you have to do is lean and trust and have faith in Him. In Jesus' name. Let's see that one more time.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Father, we just come before you tonight, God. We just give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. We thank you for who you are. We thank you that you are a way maker, Father God. We thank you that you are our peace in the storm. We thank you that you go before us and make the crooked way straight. Father, we thank you that no matter what we are going through, no matter what life throws our way, no matter what pandemics and ailments and situations, no matter what's going on around us, Father, that your word says you will never leave us nor forsake us. God, and I just ask that you would have your way, or that your spirit would not only be evident in this room, but that it would transpire through the internet and into other, whoever's watching this, Father. Your spirit knows no boundaries. You have no limitations. So the same spirit that is in this room, Father God, that sweet spirit, I ask that it would penetrate the screens of everybody who is watching, Father God, the very hearts and souls. And we just give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, thank you for joining us. Give it up for, you can't at home, but yeah. Do you like a wave? I don't know, do you like a wave in the comment section or something to let the worship team know? They did a phenomenal job. It is awesome. I don't know about you guys, but for me, it was good to feel almost a sense of normalcy, right? I don't know, did you feel that? Like,
yeah.
Like having, we had, you couldn't see her, but we had Miss Jackie back in the background. We had Olivia, we had Nevisig in the background, we had Maji on. So it was just good. We had Summer joining us with worship, and then we had obviously my beautiful wife and her beautiful voice, and then we had Hannah. And so it was just awesome to have, you know, we're starting to come back together little by little. Hopefully we could have more teens join us throughout the, you know, as we go forward. It was just good. And it's also good, Facebook, seeing all, man, I saw a lot of preacher friends join and leave comments, and local pastor here in Pueblo, Tim Aragon, thanks for dropping by. I see my man Bethel Archuleta. If anybody's watching and you're in the Denver area and you need a church and you don't have a home church, I need you to look up my boy Bethel Archuleta, one of the best worship leaders you will come across. Definitely, if you get a chance, what's up, Bethel Archuleta, Tim Aragon. I saw Dusty, my man Dusty again, Dusty Morris. He's a pastor up north. I always forget. I know it's a small town. It's a small town, like outside of Denver. I want to say Sterling, but I'm not sure. But hey, thank you, Dusty, for joining us.
Dusty, drop us a comment. We know where you are.
Yeah, drop us a comment. Let us know where you're watching from. All of my out of folk town. Drop us a comment. I see our leadership, Destiny. I saw Destiny drop by. Our teens, our ID teens, it's coming kind of fast. So, hey, man, why don't you leave a comment? Let us know where you're watching from. Let us know if my boy Rob Goulet, Pastor Rob from AGF out in Pueblo West, their youth group meets on Thursday nights. So they check us out on Wednesday. We check them out on Thursday. So good stuff there. Love Pastor Rob.
Did you say Wesley? Did you say hi to Wesley?
Oh, my man, yes, my man Wesley. What's up, Wesley? Love you, buddy. I'll see you Sunday. Oh, I haven't seen him at church yet, but when you come to church, we are open. So for those of you who attend Praise as your church, we are open on Sunday mornings. We have two services. at 9 o'clock and then at 10:30. They do have social distancing, so we have taped off areas. So it's a little different if you haven't come, but it's also still, it's just good to be in the house of God with fellow worshipers. So we love that. We're back open. We do clean very thoroughly. If you're nervous about that, we do clean very thoroughly in between services. And then we also have a separate room set up for families. If you have little ones and maybe you don't want to be in the worship center, we do have another room set up with tables that are distanced, and you can sit with your family at a table. There's coloring for the kiddos. They have stuff for like that. Anything else I am missing? Anything else?
If they're not anybody? On our group chat for text,
yes.
Send us their phone number.
So yes, RID fam, students, we are sending out texts with information of upcoming things. So if we don't have, if you haven't received a text from myself or Rochelle, make sure you shoot us a message. Let us know. I know I was going through trying to find all my contacts. I know there's a lot of the fellas that I missed. I'm in charge of contacting the fellas. Rochelle is in charge of contacting the ladies. So if you didn't
drop your Snapchat,
yeah, hit us up on Snap, Insta, Facebook. You know, all those social media outlets. All right, I'm going to get a TikTok pretty soon. I just heard no from the cheap seats over here. I don't know what that's about. But anyway, so yeah, thanks again for joining us. Tonight we're going to continue. If you are joining us for the first time tonight in a while, or if it's your first time joining us, I just want to say thank you for joining us. You know, let's get caught up. So we're in the middle of we're kind of at the tail end of a series we titled Battle Scars. And in the first week, we talked about choosing your battles. We talked about that you know, there's that phrase, choose your battles. And we talked about how sometimes we got to learn in life to choose our battles. And whoever coined that phrase understood that in life we will have battles. Sometimes, they're little battles. Like, you know, whose turn is it to do the dishes? We have that battle constantly in this house. And all I know is it's never my turn to do dishes. I do the outside stuff. When I said I do right here, that was one of the agreements that me and Rochelle had, is that I do all the outside stuff. As she don't have to mow the grass ever, and I don't have to do dishes. But now I don't have to mow the grass either because my man Maji does it. But anyway, so that battle happens all the time at our house. There's other battles, right? But sometimes you can't choose your battle. We talked about that. We talked about, well, what happens if I can't choose my battle? What happens if I find myself in the middle of a battle? And then we talked about the enemy in me. A couple of Wednesdays ago, two Wednesdays ago, we talked about the enemy in me. We talked about how sometimes we give the devil too much credit. We talk about how, like, you know, back in the day on our cartoons, we would, you know, the cartoon would show a little angel on one side and a little devil on the other side. And sometimes we see that, you know, where we feel that, we hear that voice saying, do it. And then we hear that other voice saying, don't do it. And we give the devil too much credit. We say, oh, well, the devil tempted me, or the devil made me do it. In reality, it's your flesh. So we talked about the enemy in me, or the enemy. That enemy that's in me. And then Miss Jackie tore it up last Wednesday. She did live. Her and her family, they tore up worship and she tore up the word. So tonight we're going to continue back on battle scars. And I'm going to try to finish up this series on next week. But tonight we're going to talk about the other enemy. You know, the Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. We do have an enemy. Not only do we struggle against ourselves, not only do we have that battle that we face within ourselves, we also have a spiritual enemy. And in 2 Timothy, the book of 2 Timothy was the last letter that the Apostle Paul wrote to his a young man named Timothy that he was mentoring. Young men, young ladies, if you find a mentor, a godly man, a godly woman, I encourage you to find a godly man, a godly woman who could mentor you, who could help you through life. That's what Paul and Timothy were. Paul was the mentor, Timothy was the student. And Paul wrote this last letter to Timothy. Paul knew his days were numbered. He knew his time on earth was drawing to an end. He knew that he wouldn't have much time to say what was on his heart and what was on his mind. So he wrote this letter to Timothy. And in chapter 2, in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 23 to 24, the Bible says this: "Flee the evil desires of youth and pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace." You see, the Apostle Paul understood too that you have to flee those inward desires, right? We talked about the enemy in me, and that's what Paul's talking about, those natural desires. You see, God gave us some desires, right? It's natural. When my kids were growing up, I would tell my son, it's natural for you to one day to start, you know, thinking, hey man, that girl's cute and this girl's cute. And I told my daughters, it's natural for you to begin to take in, you know, a liking to certain boys. But there's a line that God designed. And there are things that God designed for marriage. And when we allow our flesh to push through that line or cross that line, then things come along with that. And that's what Paul is telling Timothy. He's saying, flee the evil desires of youth. We all have those growing up. You teenagers, you high school and middle school students, you're going to have earthly desires. You're going to have they're natural desires. You're going to, man, that girl over there, she's cute, right? The girl at the, you know, in the lunch line, you see that guy, he's got that six pack, right? You know, and I know, we all know, right? If you're in high school, you know the kids who have six packs because they show everybody they have them, right? And I'm kind of salty because I didn't have one in high school. Even though I worked out, I never had a six pack. But we all know that kid, right? The one's like, he's always walking around with his shirt off. I digress. But anyway, so it goes on to say to pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace, along with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. Don't have anything to do with foolish and stupid arguments, because you know they produce quarrels or fights. Again, he says it plain as day. Don't have anything to do with foolish or stupid arguments, because you know they produce quarrels or fights. Verse 24, and the Lord's servants must not be quarrelsome, but must be kind to everyone, able to teach, not resentful. I'm going to go back a little bit, because Paul's teaching us, when we face battles, when we face this enemy, we must take action. And the first action we must do is we must flee. We must run from. We must exit, right? If you ever find yourself in a situation, if you ever find yourself, at a party, you know, you shouldn't be at, and there's things going on, you know, they shouldn't be going on, you should get yourself out of that situation. Paul is saying, flee those desires. Whenever you find yourself alone, young lady, with that boy, and his hands start creeping in areas that, I'm going to get real with you for a minute. When his hands start creeping in areas you know they shouldn't be creeping in, flee that situation. Young boys, whenever you're with your friends and they start wanting to do things you know you shouldn't be doing, you have to flee that situation. And in today's society, I know all you cats have phones. All of you have access to just text somebody, snap somebody, message somebody, come pick me up, right?
Come on.
So the Bible teaches us to flee. You have to take action. This life, this journey we call the Christian life, we learned in week one that it's a battle. You're going to face fights. You're going to face battles. And in a battle, you can't just lay back. We can't just kick our feet up and expect Jesus and God to do everything for us. We have to take action. The next thing that the Bible teaches us to do is Paul says, you must pursue righteousness. You see, I'm a huge football fan. And there's that age-old, battle between football players. Who wins championships, right? All my defensive guys, you know, if you've played football and you're a defensive guy, drop a comment. Who wins championships? Defensive guys are going to say defense. Offensive guys are going to say offense. My linemen are going to say linemen. Your defense is going to say, well, if we don't stop them, we won't win, right? And your offense is going to say, well, if we don't score points, we're not going to win. But the Bible teaches us that you have to do both. You have to have a strong defense and a strong offense in order to be successful. And you'll learn that as a team. Any successful team, any team that has won a national championship, a Super Bowl, a World Series, an NBA title, any team that has won a World Cup, you know they have a strong defense and they have a strong offense. And the Bible tells us that our defense is that we must flee from those evil desires. But we must also take it one step further. We must pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace. Righteousness and peace. So we have to, again, we have to have offense and defense. But here's the kicker. Check this out. And this is hard to do during COVID, I understand. But when churches do open up, and Praise Assembly is open up, you have to have a strong team, right? You ever see that team who has, they've got a strong quarterback, or they've got a strong receiver, or a strong running back, but they're weak, their line is weak. Or maybe they've got a great lineman, or a great linebacker, or a great safety, but their corners are weak, right? No matter how strong that one person is, if he doesn't have the support of his team, that team is going to fail. Listen to what Paul tells Timothy. Listen to this wisdom. He says, you must pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace along with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. Not just those who go to youth group, not just those who go to church because their mom and dad make them, but you have to do this with those that pursue the Lord out of a pure heart. You know, growing up, I used to hear all kinds of things. Some of them I can't repeat. But one of the things I used to hear all the time was, tell me who your friends are, and I'll tell you who you are. Or, birds of a feather flock together. And the Bible is teaching us that right here. Paul, the Apostle Paul is saying that, you know, if you want to be successful in this thing we call the Christian journey, you have to live life with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. He goes on to say, don't have anything to do with foolish and stupid arguments. It seems like in this generation, in your generation, high school, middle school students, I see it all the time on social media. It's like a perfect platform. You're not going to change their mind, and hopefully they're not going to change your mind. So don't get caught up in foolish and stupid arguments about this and about that. It seems like in today's society, you have all these people posting all these things about what's going on in this society, right? About this statue or that statue, or this message or that mural or this mural, or this matters or that matters, or these lives do matter and those don't matter. You can have a civil discussion, and you know who the people are that you can sit down with and you can have a good discussion. You can lay out your point of view and your perspective. You can hear their perspective. You can hear their point of view. At the end of the day, you can shake hands and you can go your separate way. And then you know those who just want to argue. And the Bible teaches us, don't waste your time with that. Because all that's going to do is lead to fights. And what it's going to do even more than that is it's going to ruin your testimony. Rochelle, my wife, says this all the time. She would rather... How do you say it?
I would rather allow my voice to be used for Jesus than for political reasons.
She would rather use her voice to be used for Jesus than political reasons.
Because people will shut you out if they don't agree with you.
Because people will shut you out if they don't agree with you. We're going to have to tighten that up a little bit, but that's good.
T-shirt.
Yes. And I agree with that. When I'm a firm believer that if you're of age, get out there and vote. I'm a firm believer in exercising your American rights. I'm a firm believer in exercising your God-given rights, whatever you know those are outside of your nation. But don't ruin your testimony for political gain. Don't lose your ability to influence others for the kingdom of God because we're looking at earthly kingdoms. So make sure that you use your voice wisely. And don't get caught up in foolish and stupid arguments. Again, I'm a firm believer in exercising your right to vote. I'm a firm believer in not allowing others to silence you. for what you believe in, but also be careful that you don't get in arguments with fools. All right? And then verse 24, it says, "And the Lord's servants must not be quarrelsome, but must be kind to everyone." Mm-hmm. So it's what he's saying is, man, don't be stirring up fights, and be kind to everyone. And it's hard. See, once you get involved in the foolishness and the stupid arguments, it's hard to then go back and show kindness. So the first thing to do and the best thing to do is enter it with kindness. Enter it with God's wisdom. Sometimes, and it's hard to do, but when you know they're just wanting to argue, just bite that tongue, right? Put that phone away, man. Turn that off, because you always want to bark back. I know I do. And God has taught me how to just say, hey, man, this is not the right time. So I hope this was helpful in our series, Battle Scars. And I hope this helps somebody tonight. And I just want to pray as we wind up tonight's service. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come before you tonight. Once again, God, giving you honor, glory, and praise. God, I ask that the words that I spoke tonight will have penetrated the very hearts and souls of all the students who are watching tonight. God, I ask that they would use this this teaching to help them along their journey, Father God, along their life, and that you would just receive all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen and amen. Hey, love you guys. Again, see you this Sunday morning. I'm out of town with my beautiful wife. It's our anniversary. Oh. Okay, no. So it's our anniversary this weekend, so me and my beautiful bride, we're going out of town. But for those of you who are here in town, check out Praise Assembly if you don't have a home church. For my ID students, I keep looking out for you every Sunday morning, and I don't see you guys.
Where you been?
Yeah, where you at? Now, if your parents are not letting you go, that's one thing. But if I catch you on social media at your friend's crib or at the somewhere else, I'm going to go snatch you up. All right? Love you guys. Hey, and stay connected. Check us out on Insta, on Facebook, to know when we're going to open up Identity. Hopefully, we'll be able to open up sooner than later, but I'm not sure how soon. So, love you guys. See you next time. And if you don't know, now you know. Is that it?